My name is Roddy, and we are at Elendonnen Castle. I'm Loch Alsh.
We're supposed to be playing in Skye, in Portree, in tomorrow night.
But we're supposed to meet here. No one else is here, really, so just have to wait.
Unlike other bands that travel in our expensive on coaches, we travel in a Nissan Micra and a rubbish Saab. So the Nissan Micra's here, but the rubbish Saab's still somewhere outside Fort William, I think.
Last year we did a tour and we played in Orkney Islands, and we were kind of encouraged by the reaction that we decided to play in different places, such as Skye. It's not like we think we're some ambassadors of culture or anything like that.
Rod, Colin and I met in the first few weeks of university and toyed with the idea of starting a band and just got going, and then, in fact, Bob was about the only person that ever come to see us play, so he eventually joined the band. This is a film about the
future. It is the future of your life. You think it's hiya. Nothing is certain. Thanks a lot.
Bye-bye.
Now, this bridge was actually quite frightening, because it goes really high, because it's got to let ships go underneath. Like, look how high it goes. I know when you think this film
is about you. Definitely not worth a fiver over that bridge. I am the best message out of the rest of them. Are you all alone? Are you all alone? You're selling your soul. You're selling your soul. Have you got it cold? Your eyes cold. With your eyes closed. Your eyes cold.
I can't even imagine what the venue's going to be like, let alone how people are going to react to the songs.
I kind of envisioned it being kind of like this weird little place where there's nobody there, just lots of sheep, but it's probably not like that at all. It's probably like a proper town that has electricity and stuff.
We didn't form a band because we wanted to make a lot of money or anything like that, you know? We kind of stumbled along.
Because we just choose to write songs about things we know about, they are just kind of related to, you know, being young and being Scottish at this time.
The place is just totally different to anywhere else in the world, really. When it happens, you'll feel like an islander. You'll see ships and there'll be reminders that you're on an island. And I'm on an island. Much bigger than expected to be.
It's kind of like a Sunday school hall, isn't it?
I'm a bit worried about how big it is and the fact that it probably won't be very full.
It's just more interesting, really, coming up here for a day than sitting about in a van in some city.
A lot of folks sort of think, you know, bassists going to stand in the back. They're not really doing a great deal, and it's like a bit of a boring job to do, but, you know, guitarists or singers or rest of the band can be as good as they want, but if you haven't got a really strong rhythm section, then everything just sounds terrible.
I played sort of classical instruments as a child, and I always found it quite difficult to play sort of Sonic Youth on the trombone, so I asked my parents for a guitar and they sort of grudgingly gave me one.
Something. You must be scared of something.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is it putting you off a lot?
Yeah, it's
kind of
weird.
Yeah. It sounds like we're in fucking Wembley Stadium. It's ridiculous. It's like, boom! Like, you know. So, I mean, if you want to do a couple with the front off, and then we'll just do the first number with it on.
It's my first gig, and I really like Idlewild, so, like, great. We'd be slagged off in school if we're going to miss it. The biggest thing that's come to Portree, apparently, since Run Rig.
They made the effort to come to Sky, which is pretty cool. No one else ever does.
Different.
Apart from Run Rig.
Oh, Run Rig are crap, though.
Yeah.
We've seen them between us 24 times, and after this, it's going to be about 39 times. Very sad.
Sad. We're here to watch a band play and dance.
I heard them on Radio 1.
Yes,
yeah, Radio 1 quite a lot, late at night, and they sound quite good.
They sort of captured your teenage fears and frustrations, and they spin it round and they make it beautiful, and it's lovely, and they can express that. And people relate to that, the lyrics. And the music's noisy and punky, and we get to jump around, and that helps.
I'm focused now.
Of the music, it's quite energetic, so people do sort of feed off that energy.
When we started out, I think the live gigs, we tended to try and prove ourselves by jumping up and down and making as much noise as possible, probably because we couldn't really play an instrument. Hopefully now, you know, we've learned to play.
So much.
They were fantastic!
They have real punky energy.
Stop it!
Best thing Sky's ever had.
This is the best concert I've ever been to.
Honestly.
And I've been to a lot of concerts.
This is Donny Monroe's son, Run Rig!
Run Rig!
Run Rig!
You want to cut that bit out?
All that communist sloganing. It really made me want to take up arms for a revolution.
You want all the other bands to come up now, you've seen how great Sky is.
Ha ha.
I couldn't actually tell what was going on because of the serious echo. It was like an Aphex Twin record. We're actually in it.
Too tight.
Vinny, you just found us tiara in Paris.
A bit of after-show babysitting.
Oh, who's that?
So you?
Yeah,
oh,
did you just find it? Oh, thank you very much. Bye.
You got a ring from Amy.
Yes, you follow.
Can I get Colin's autograph? My mum's waiting on me. How old are you? I'm 8. Where's Colin? Bob said I can come in and see Colin. I'm not meant to look after 8-year-olds. It's not in the job description.
I think we'll just carry on doing what we do, you know, until someone tells us we can't do it anymore. Which hopefully won't be for a long time.